Hi friends, today I have two people who have been responsible for the arrangement of insectivorous plants. I request them to introduce themselves.
Myself Chandan Gowda, I am an horticulture graduate.
Myself Kishorin, I have done my BS agriculture from GKUK.
So it's very good to see how many species of Nepenthes and the insectivorous plant you were able to collect.
Altogether we have around 40 insectivorous collections.
Okay.
Among them we have 17 Nepenthes species.
Okay.
And others are we have 3 Venus flytrap, 2 pinguiculas and rest with Droseras.
Which was the difficult plant to collect?
To be frank, all the insectivorous are not easy to get because these are under extinction state and these are not commonly found in any nurseries. So I had to travel abroad, like last month I had been to Bangkok. There I got collected some of the Saracenas and Venus flytraps. So other than that, I have an contact with a hobbyist who import some of the Nepenthes species for me. And the rest I have collected from, each plant was collected from different places in India, from different hobbies.
Assam you had been to, Nepenthes cassiana also you have collected?
Yeah, Nepenthes cassiana I have, but right now it doesn't have any pictures.
Okay.
So I have 3 plants borrowed from National Botanical Survey of India.
You had any issues getting these exported from places like Thailand to India?
No, I didn't get any issues because the person who import plants for me have an import license along with the quarantine. So he imported the plants 6 months ago and he acclimatizes for Indian conditions and he gave me the plants.
So your dwarf variety of Nepenthes you have. So where did you collect it from?
So Nepenthes dwarf variety was collected from northeastern parts of India. So in a place called Nagaon. So the
which state, sir?
Sir?
Which state?
Assam. Yeah. That person hybridized some of the Nepenthes species. He has age-old plants. He usually pollinate with different species and get the hybrids. We have some triple cross hybrids also here.
Okay.
Other than that, we have a good collection of Saracenias. So those are...
How is Saracenia different? Is it also an insectivorous plant? Or
yeah, that's an insectivorous plant. It has a pitfall trap method similar to Nepenthes species. Actually, Saracenias are surface growing plants, which grow in a very boggy and acidic soil.
Mm-hmm.
Usually found in North American states.
What is your future plan? Now you have done the collection.
My future plan is in India, we don't have any particular nurseries for insectivorous plants. And
germplasm preservation.
Yeah, even people are not aware of such insectivorous plants. This is the first time we have displayed so many insectivorous plants in a public show. And seeing this, even we are so feeling so happy that even people are...
lot of good responses.
Yeah. So future plan is to propagate them and multiply, collect some more species and introduce it to colleges and universities.
Now you collected all these plants as a part of your research work or?
This is a part of my research work. So I need to figure out the propagation techniques, I need to multiply them. And the main intention is to provide these to schools and colleges because most of the students who are learning in the books are... there is a misunderstanding in the book, a wrong printing. Because usually, whenever you ask a child how the Nepenthes trap the insect, they tell that an insect goes inside the pitfall and the upper flip closes. But that's not the thing. Because upper flip is a modification to prevent the excess rainwater drowning into the pitfall.
Right.
So that's the modification, but there is a wrong information printed in all the literatures.
So they also have downwardly pointed hairs,
yeah.
Mucus,
yeah.
Walls.
Mucus, digestive enzymes, and some of the Nepenthes species have colonized the bacteria for better digestion also.
Okay.
Mainly Saracenias. But in case of Venus flytrap, digestion occurs from enzymes.
Apart from as ornamental plants, can you also have them as a mosquito repellent? Is it possible?
You can't have them as a mosquito repellent because according to mosquitoes doesn't have sensory organs which is being attracted by the insectivorous plants. Most of the time mosquitoes multiply in Nepenthes because there will be a water storage there. The larvae multiply there. But usually most of the time insects trapped are ants, honeybees, wasps and some spiders.
Any other economic importance apart from ornamental?
These have a medicinal value too. It is used against constipation and curing some other diseases.
Which part is utilized?
Entire stem. Yeah. Other than that, different pictures look amazing. This can be used as a hanging plant. But the main constraint in Bangalore is humidity is not up to the mark. Mm-hmm. So we'll have to enhance the humidity by keeping them in a terrarium.
Now, in case, will they grow in a soil which is rich in nitrogen?
No, never. So these plants cannot be grown in a nutrient-rich medium. So a sterilized, completely leached nutrient-deficient soil has to be used for growing them. So each species have different media requirements. Mm. Like Nepenthes require cocoa peat with nutrient-deficient cocoa peat along with a slightly acidic pH. And we can add some perlite for better aeration. For Venus flytrap and all, we need sphagnum moss.
Okay.
Because it require more humidity. And Drosera's require high humidity. Relative humidity.
Some species are available in Nagamangala, the boulders. Where had you been there for Drosera varieties?
Yeah, there is a Drosera species identified in Saklespura, but I could not go there. But one of the my client had been there and collected some seeds and plants. And they had sent me there. But right now we don't have not a germinator.
Now what are the most propagative methods? Is it vegetative or sexual?
The main concern is propagation of insectivorous plants. Because Nepenthes starts flowering from 6 to 7 years. In southern condition it starts from 7 years. In high humidity and northern condition they start from 5 years. And here the male and female plants are completely different plants. So again, there is a constraint in synchronizing the flowering period. So when female flower first and followed by male, so it can't be pollinated and the whole female flower is wasted. When male flower flowers the first time and second the female, so pollens can be collected and cryopreserved.
No self-pollination.
It's completely cross-pollination. The pollens can be collected and hand-pollinated to get the fertile seed. In case of Drosera, Venus flytrap, and all, they are self-pollinated. So seeds can be easily extracted. You can see some of the plants are there in flowering also. Pinnaculus can be propagated by leaf pulling. Even Venus flytrap can be propagated by leaf pulling and seed method. Ceracinius by sucker suppression. Drosera are completely from seeds. So Nepenthes seeds take almost 3 months for germination and 1.5 years for first picture production.
Thank you for that wonderful information. Best wishes for both of you. Hope you continue with this work. We require people like you to conserve the biodiversity.
Sure.
Thank you. Have a nice, wonderful flower show ahead. Thank you.